बड़वन मॉडल स्कूल थ्रू आनंदवार्ता न्यूज चैनल. इट इज़ अ नोबल इनिशिएटिव टू इम्पार्ट एजुकेशन और टू प्रोवाइड अनइंटरप्टेड एजुकेशनल सर्विसेज टू द चिल्ड्रन हु आर अनेबल टू गो टू स्कूल बिकॉज ऑफ दिस आउटब्रेक ऑफ द पैंडमिक COVID-19. बट वी आर रियली फॉर्चुनेट दैट द टेक्नोलॉजी हैज़ इम्प्रूव टू सच एन एक्सटेंट दैट चिल्ड्रन सिटिंग सेफ एट होम यू कैन गेट एजुकेशनल हेल्प. एंड बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द क्लास आई वॉन्ट टू कंग्रेचुलेट द चिल्ड्रन दोज हु हैव बीन सक्सेसफुली प्रोमोटेड टू क्लास 9. एंड इट इज़ फ्रॉम हियर दैट यू आर स्टार्टिंग अ न्यू चैप्टर ऑफ योर लाइफ एज यू आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द बोर्ड सिलेबस ऑफ क्लास 10. यू हैव नाउ बीन एनरोल्ड और बीइंग रजिस्टर्ड एज अ स्टूडेंट ऑफ द बोर्ड. एंड हियर आई एम नसरीन बेगम हु इज़ एन असिस्टेंट टीचर ऑफ बड़वन मॉडल स्कूल. And now I'm here to take class for class 9. And the book which I am going to take will be of Democratic Politics, Part 1, what you usually know as your civics. So once again, welcome you all. Hope this class will be of quite a help to you. And the chapter, now as per the syllabus of your class 9 suggested by the board, chapter 1, you are not going to be evaluated on chapter 1. It will be internal assessment for chapter 1. So for your board assessment, that means you will be assessed, evaluated by means of your question paper. It will be from your chapter 2. And chapter 1 will be for your internal assessment, which will include a number of activities which will be suggested by the school itself. So for chapter 1, we are going to start with the chapter which is now this particular word democracy. I know that many of you are acquainted, that means you know, you have several times you have gone through this term democracy. Now the question comes, if you have heard this word, and we all know that India is one of the largest liberal democratic states in the world. So before starting something about democracy, let us in short, in brief, know about what is democracy. Now before knowing what is democracy, let me talk to you something about the origin of democracy, that is from where, or the roots from where the word democracy has actually come up. The word comes from a Latin word demos, which means people. So here you are getting an idea that within this term democracy, people are playing an important part. An important part is always played by the people of the country, that is the citizens. The citizen of a country plays a very vital role in a democracy. Democracy is actually a form of government. And this particular word demos, it came up somewhere in the Greek city-state of Athens, somewhere in 508 BC to 507 BC. This is the time period where I have told you, and what is the particular word from which democracy owes its origin. Origin from means the roots, the particular term from where this particular word democracy which has been taken. So this is a brief picture of the origin of the word democracy, which is at present the most popular form of government all over the world, that is all over the globe. You know, democracy has been universally accepted as the best form of government. No other government can be a substitute for democracy. So we have seen about the origin, the word, from where, what time period. Now we will come to know about the meaning of democracy. So democracy is a form of government. So I'm going to do it in a flow chart. It is a form of government where the absolute, you see, I will give you some words which will define you the meaning. Absolute sovereign or supreme, I'm putting them in a slash because all will mean the same thing. Unlimited power of the people of the country. So, democracy is a form of government where the absolute power or the sovereign power or the supreme power or the unlimited power or the unquestionable power, whatever, which is in the hands of the people of the country. Now, how do the people exercise this power? The people exercise this power means this supreme, absolute, unlimited, sovereign power by giving votes during elections. So, now many of us may, children at times they ask, Miss, if in a democracy the sovereign power is in the hands of the people, but I cannot see this power, I cannot feel this power. So for that only I've given you this one, the next point, that this power is what? This power is your power to give votes during election, which is given to you as a right to vote by the constitution of the country where that particular citizen is living. So we use this power for giving our votes. So after giving votes, what do? We choose our representatives who will form the government. That means after we have given our votes to the party or the candidate of our choice, what happens? We choose some representatives amongst us, and these representatives means people. Representatives means people on behalf of us. Us means the whole population. These representatives will do what? They will go and form the government. Now, many a times, you know, I have come across this question that, Miss, if we have the power in our hands, but that means in a democracy, if the final power or the supreme power or the sovereign power is in the hands of the people, why don't we go and form the government? Now, imagine of a country like India where you are having so much of population. Then if all of us, we go and we rush to the parliament and we say that I will go and take a seat here, I will sit here because also I am a citizen of a country, I have the right to do that. So what will happen? The whole parliament house, within few moments, it will be shattered to the ground. It will turn into dust particles. So it is not possible to accommodate all the population. So what do? We choose representatives. And these representatives, they come from where? They come from different political parties. They take part by giving candidates, and we go that we means the people, those who have the right to vote, who are 18 years and above, we go and give our votes to the person or to the candidate or the party to which we like, and we go and give the vote. Because it is not possible for all of us to go and rush into the parliament house or the legislature and we say that we will take a seat here because we have actually voted. So it is not possible to accommodate all the people. So what happens? We select representatives from ourselves and by means of giving our votes, and then it is a representative democracy. And in this way, the people in a democracy, they exercise their power of giving votes and they form the government. So I think all of you should repeat with me wherever you are. So what is democracy? Democracy is a form of government where the absolute or the sovereign power is in the hands of the people, and this power is exercised by the citizens by means of giving votes and during elections. And after elections, what happens? The party or the candidate which gets the absolute majority vote, they form the government. So up till this will be one part of democracy. And one more part which I will tell you is that, which is also the best part of our democracy, is that the best part of our democracy is that this is also one of the reasons why democracy is regarded to be the best form of government. That is, a democracy gives to its people certain rights and freedoms. This is very, very important. It is only in a democracy that people, that is the citizens of the country, they get certain rights and freedoms. Now you will ask me that, Miss, why do we need rights and freedoms? You know, rights and freedoms are needed. Why? Because without rights and freedoms, you know, you can... with the help of rights and freedoms, we can rights and freedoms which will help a person to develop the inherent talents. Inherent means every person, you know, they are unique. Why unique? Because we are born from our birth. God has actually sent everyone on this particular planet with some kind of special talent or skill, or I'll say that some kind of a potential. And until and unless you get that opportunity to develop that potential, you can never grow up to the level what you dream of. For example, you see that you are very good at playing. You are very good at playing football. Yes, you get that opportunity to get to be put under the guidance of a good coach. If you don't get all the kits which you require for learning football, you know, you can never develop yourself as a full-fledged footballer. Or for example, you are very good at singing. But you have that quality, you are born with that quality, you have that rhythm in you. But until and unless you are put under the guidance of a good guru, or if you don't have all the instruments for, by means of which you can learn singing, you cannot fulfill your dream. So these dreams are necessary. You can fulfill your dreams if you are given certain rights and freedoms. If your parents identify that you have this quality and they arrange for you a good teacher and all the other things, one day you are certainly going to develop yourself. And that is also democracy. What is democracy is regarded to be the best form, because democracy gives you all the rights and freedoms, all the opportunities, all the facilities which are required for you to develop your personality to the utmost level. So now let us put together what we have learned so far as to what is democracy. So a democracy is regarded to be a best form of government. It is such a government where the sovereign power, you can write anything, you can write supreme power also, it is in the hands of the people, and the people exercise this power by means of giving votes during elections. And by doing this, the party or the candidate which gets the ultimate vote, you know, ultimate or the absolute majority of votes, forms the government. And one more thing which is very, very important, or very best part of a democracy, is that democracy gives to its people certain rights and freedoms which help a person to develop their inherent talents or personality to the utmost level. This is what a democracy is all about. I suppose this much you can understand. Now you are getting an idea that you were hearing about democracy so much. Now what is democracy? Once again, just recapitulating from where does this word democracy come from? It came from the word demos, which is the Latin word, and it came from a Greek city-state which was known as Athens, and it means, demos means people. So we can understand an important role played by the people in this particular term democracy, and it came somewhere around 508 to 507 BC. And democracy till date, you know, most of the countries of the world are democratic in nature, and it is regarded to be the best form of government. And here the absolute power is in the hands of the people, who use this in the form of giving votes, forming the government. And another important part of a democracy is that it gives to its people rights and freedoms which help them to form their personality, or to nurture their personality, or to nurture their talents to the best possible level. This is I have described about what is democracy. Now I will talk about what are the features of democracy. Now, herein, this is the best thing, is that if you have understood the definition part, most of the features you can draw from there only. Features of a democratic country or a democracy or a democratic state. First of all, in a democracy, you will find that sovereign power is in the hands of the people. As I have already told you, that sovereign power is in the hands of the people, that is, supreme power is in the hands of the people. Secondly, the people in a democracy, they form the government through elections. As I've already told you, that in a democracy, people exercise their power by means of elections. But these elections must be what? They must be free. That means people must be free to express their choice. Nobody should force them that you have to vote this particular candidate or this particular party. It should be free
fair. Fair means no malpractices, no cheating, nothing. And regular manner. Regular means not every day. Every country has a time period for forming the government. For example, in India, we have a time of 5 years. For if you go to America, we have a time of, for Americans, the time period of a government is for 4 years. If you go to Britain, it is for 4.5 years. Again, if you go to for Mexico, it is for 6 years. If you go to China, it is again for 5 years. So every country has a time period for a particular government. So that is regular. Regular means not every day. So the people in a democracy, what they do, they form the government through elections. And what should be the nature of these elections? It should be free, fair and regular. Third, the government in a democracy are responsible for all its acts to the people. This is also a very, very important point. That is, the government in a democracy are responsible for all its acts to the people. As I've told you for the definition part, meaning part, that in a democracy, who forms the government? In a democracy, the government is formed by the people. By means of what? By means of elections, they go, people, those who have right to vote, that means those who have reached the age of elections, that is in India as we are having 18 years. So those who are having this right to vote, they go and they form the government. But remember one thing. So, for example, take for me, I am more than 18 years. So what will happen? I have the right to vote. One particular day, I will go, I will give my vote and my work is over. I have given my vote. I have stand in a line. I've made a queue for whole day. I've stood there and I have given my votes and my job is over. No, your job is not over, my dear. Here you are, work here. Your work starts. That means the person or the candidate whom you have chosen to form the government or to run the government of the country, they must always be responsible to you. And how will you know that they are responsible to you? That is, you have to, people must keep a watch upon the activities of the government. Now, you know, before election, political leaders, parties, they make huge promises that after, let us vote for us, let us come to power, and after we come to power, you will see that we will do this, we will do this. I don't know, unfortunately, most of them are not fulfilled. So it is our duty that the promises which the political parties and their leaders have made before us, before elections, whether they are keeping up to those promises or not, whether they are fulfilling our expectations or not, it is our responsibility. That means we always have to keep a thorough watch upon the activities of the government. That means only giving of vote is not my task. My task is, after giving votes, the party who has come to power, they are working according to the expectations of the people. And here, if the people find that they are not working upon the expectations of the people have the right to remove the government. How they will remove? They will go and they will pull their hands and they will remove them from the chair. No, they will say that the people nationwide, what they will do, they will say that we don't support this particular government, the government to which we have supported last elections, no more, and the government will be dissolved. So the president of the country will have to issue a notice that this government has failed to keep up to the expectations of the people, and this particular government needs to be dissolved, and the country will be now moving up to a fresh election. So the four points which I have written just now, that is, in a democracy the sovereign power is in the hands of the people. This power we exercise by means of elections which take place in a free, fair and regular manner. The government in a democracy, they are always responsible to the people, because it is the people, those who have elected them, and people also have the right to remove the government if the government is not working up to the expectations of the people. And as already told you, that a democracy gives to its people certain rights and freedoms. As already told to you, that without these rights and freedoms, they come in the form of opportunities, and these opportunities will help you to develop your inherent talents, inherent potentials, and you will become what you want to be, what you dream of, or what you have dreamt of becoming. So these are the reasons, these are the features of a democracy, why democracy is now regarded to be the best form of the government. At least 5 points will be enough for a question, because at times when a question comes that explain the features of a democracy, if it comes for a 5 marks question, it will be expected by the examiner that at least 5 points you have to write. So these are the features of democracy. Now we will see that now, so far I was telling you that democracy, most of the countries of the world have now turned to be a democratic government, and it is universally accepted that democratic government is the best government. Now, the reason, now we will talk about why a democracy is the best form of government, or in another way you can place it, what are the advantages or what are the merits of a democracy. First one, democracy democracy gives the power in the hands of the people, as we have already talked about. So this particular feeling that the power is in the hands of the people, that I, my valuable vote, although it is I have a power of one vote, I have given my votes, and my one vote is has also contributed to the forming of this government. This particular feeling, you know, it gives you, makes you feel supreme as well as a part of the government which is running in the country. It gives you a feeling of superiority, a feeling of being a part of this nation, a feeling of being a part of this government of the country. This creates a feeling of, like, you know, pride, a feeling of responsibility, a feeling of belongingness and others. Secondly, democracy gives us an accountable
responsive and legitimate government. Democracy gives us an accountable, responsive and legitimate government. Accountable means they are answerable. The people, those who have formed the government, those who are a part of the government, those who are sitting there, or those who are running the government of the country, they are accountable. Accountable means answerable to us for whatever activities they are undergoing. They are responsive. Responsive means they are responsible to us, whether they are fulfilling the expectations of the people of the country or not. And legitimate means legal. That means they have not got the power by force, but they have got the power legally by means of elections, where the people have willingly given them the powers. So democracy gives us an accountable government. Once again, accountable government means a government which is answerable to the people. Responsive means responsible to the needs and interests of the people of the country. And legitimate means they have legally or lawfully got the powers. They have not snatched away the powers. They have not taken away the power. They have lawfully got the powers. Thirdly, in a democracy, people's wishes are given priority. So, as we have already talked about that, democracy is all about a people's government. So, here, whenever a government frames any policies, frames any decisions, makes any laws, the first thing they have to do is that they have to pay attention to what the people want. Whatever laws, whatever policies which are made by the people, they are the wishes of the people. They are given that priority. People's wishes are given priority. Fourthly, people are consulted in a democracy. Whenever a government is going to take up a policy initiative, what they must have to do is that the people must be consulted. Whenever the government is taking up a decision, the people must be consulted of the country that this particular decision is being taken for the whole country, whether the people are for it or against it. And as I've already told you, rights and freedoms. Why democracy is far supreme than any other form of government. So these are some of the reasons why democracy is regarded to be a better form of government. But unfortunately, although being the best form of government, there are certain reasons or certain demerits or certain disadvantages of a democracy also. First of all, you know, ignorant people, that means all the people, those who are 18 years and above, they are given the right to vote. Because, and most of the people, if you take a country like India, most of the people are not educated. So what happens, you know, at times they don't know whom to vote. So they cannot use their power of voting wisely. So at times they give votes to a wrong party or a wrong candidate. Second, delay in decision making. As I've already told you that in a democracy, for merit part, I've told you that people must have to be consulted for taking any decision. So this can create a delay in decision making, which can also be a delay for the government to carry on its work. Thirdly, frequent change of leaders can cause instability in government or administration.
not only leaders but also parties. So, for example, as I have told you that the people have the right to keep a watch upon the activities of the government. So, if they are not satisfied, what they can do is that they can remove them. But too much of removing, you know what happens? The government which we are having, it is an unstable government. The government which we are getting is not a stable government. Government must be stable. If it is elected for a term of 5 years, let that 5 years be with them. But unfortunately, at times we have seen cases where a government has been dissolved at the head of 2 years or 2.5 years, which is not at all enough for a party or its leaders to work. Fourthly, too much of interference is unhealthy. As I've said that in a democracy, the government is accountable, answerable to the people. But all the time, if the people go on interfering in the activities of the government, what will happen? The government will become, frustrated. They will become, they will say that too much of interference is also not good. Instead of giving you good results, productive results, at times the government can become very fed up, very frustrated because of too much of interference by the people of the country. And here also you can find use of corruption in the form of money and muscle power. As in a democracy, I've told you that the power is in the hands of the people. You know what happens? Political parties and leaders, they try to buy votes. Buy means purchase votes from the poor people by giving them some money or material goods. Like, for example, they say that give us votes, I'll give you this, we'll give you some packets of food, some amount of money, one blanket given, and the people, without thinking anything, they go and give votes. And at times, you know, many parties, they have hooligan type of people, that is people they use, they can go and force a people, they can put them at a gunpoint, and they say that you have to give votes to our party, to our candidates. So you can see that corruption is also at times used in a democracy. So together with merits, democracy is also having certain demerits. But as it is having demerits, that doesn't mean that democracy should be removed. But this is universally accepted, as what I have told. It's an established phenomena that democracy is the best government. So what we need to do is that we have to remove this kinds of demerits by means of proper learning, proper orientation, proper understanding, awareness, and we will try to remove this disadvantage so that we can make democracy the best government in the world. So far in this class, we have seen from the origin of democracy, the meaning of democracy, the features of democracy, the advantages and disadvantages of democracy. I hope that this class will be helpful. And till next class, stay home, stay safe. Thank you very much. खाली भूले जाती है।